just be mine for the weekend. We can get a takeaway and sit on the couch, or we could just go out for the evening. Hopefully end up with you kissing my mouth, baby. You got it. I made a few mistakes, I regret it nightly. I broke a couple hearts and I wear on my sleeve. My mama always said, girl, you're troubling. And now I wonder, could you fall for a woman like me? Hello, my kinky people. This is Madam Posh with the MP Experience, and I'm back with another vlog for you. Today's vlog is going to be about rope, and dummy rope. Yes, we're talking about rope and suspensions, and stay tuned. Madam Posh for the MP Experience. If this is your first time to my channel, welcome. And if it is not, welcome back. If you happen to find this content valuable, informational, entertaining, please like, share, or subscribe. You can follow me on any of my social media at the MP Experience on Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter. And if you happen to like my videos enough that you want to know exactly when videos get posted, you can hit that little bell down there and it will give you notifications. But you should know that because YouTube has been out for a long time and I'm sure you follow lots of other channels. So let's talk about some rope. So this week I did a lot of rope. I mean, I know that probably sounds funny because I do lots of rope all the time, but I was focusing on a lot of new rope techniques, types of harnesses, and new challenges for suspension, trying out new things. And I learned a lot. So I'm going to share it with you because that's what my vlog is about. One of the reasons I think why I had a lot of learning this week is that me and my rope top had lots of time to talk this week. We spent probably a good 3 hours after events talking in the parking lot about rope. And I also got to go over to his house because I hadn't been over there for a while and hang out. And he got a bunch of new rope books, which are super, super cool. So fun to look at. I literally like scanned through them and did like a computer download, like one of the Westworld robots, like, let me get as much information as I can before I have to go. Because I knew I couldn't take them with me because he just got them. But one of the books that I didn't get a chance to look at until I was getting ready to leave was this one. It is called Kimbaku. I will leave. I am probably saying that so wrong. I probably should not leave, put an accent on that at all. It's called Kimbaku. Just normal. Okay. Kimbaku, The Art Rope of Bondage. I will leave a link down below because I believe you can get it on Amazon. But it is, someone said this weekend at the dungeon that it's kind of like an Instagram of rope in a book. It is kind of, but there's a lot of really, really cool, just artistic rope in this book, photography, ideas that, to be honest, I haven't seen on Instagram. So I would say that it's valuable, and it's a lovely coffee table book if you're able to be kink all over your house or if you have a kink space that you'd like to decorate in. So as well as this week being a lot about rope, which we will get into more of the exact rope learnings that I did and some of the ties that I did, but I also met lots of new people, and all of them were interested in rope, which means I spent a lot of time promoting my new group, because one of my new groups I am a leader of is about rope. The focus of the group is going to be to give consistent knowledge and learning that grows upon itself every single week, so people actually are taking something home that they are learning, comprehending, able to use in a scene, and build on that, because we need more riggers in the community. Me and my rope top are leading the group. We are not rope experts. We are still on our journey and learning, and we just happened to be learning fast and had lots of people ask us, and the dungeon owner asked me if I would help with this group, so I asked my rope top to help me as well, and we all helped each other, and we were helpful as we started the group, and now it is started, and the first day is in April, I think. It's on the first and third Sundays. So you guys will also be able to benefit from that because whatever I talk about in that group, I will be sharing on this page. Again, I want to put a disclaimer. I am not a rope expert. I am not a rope educator for lots of years. I have not done rope education at any crazy conventions. I'm literally just sharing with you and the people in the group what I've learned from other people. And I just like to put that disclaimer out there so no one comes and tries to check me because I am not saying that I am. I am still learning. And if you are an expert about rope and would like to help me, I need more help. So I worked at the dungeon on Friday night, Saturday night, and then we had one other rope group that meets once a month on Sundays. I also worked that event. So again, I spent a lot of time talking to new people and promoting my new rope group and also promoting the other new group I'm working with, which is a dominant mentoring coaching program for new dominants and for dominants at every level. We really are trying to encourage veteran dominants to come in as well and help coach and mentor newbies coming in. And I have another group leader with me in that group that's been in the community for decades. She's been kinking for decades. And so we are kind of trying to bridge the generation gap that we sometimes have within kink and give it some mentoring and coaching for dominants because, and no offense to anyone, but there is a lot of focus oftentimes on submissives and taking care of them and supporting them and making sure they are accountable to people. And there is not as much focus on dominance, doing the same thing and supporting each other and having mentors and growing and learning on things other than actual techniques and on how to throw whips or play with toys or tie rope. More things on how to make sure that you're a healthy person and that you are being a healthy dominant and that you are encouraging your sub to do things that are making them be more independent and not necessarily more dependent on you. That is a good sign of a unhealthy DS dynamic is if the top or the dominant kind of always encourages or pushes you things to do things that really only benefit them and not things that are helping you personally grow as a person. I feel like as tops and dominants, a lot of what we do in 24/7 dynamics is making sure that our submissives are growing as people. And to do that, you also have to be a whole person. You have to look internally, honestly, and see your flaws and work on them and fix them and don't let them hurt other people. So on to some of the things that I worked on with rope, and I will put pictures of the things that I'm talking about somewhere up here and here. I don't know, somewhere there will be a picture of whatever I was able to get pictures of and was given consent to share with you, because clearly they're not me in the pictures because I'm doing the tying. So I did about 4 suspension scenes this week. One of the first ones I did was with a femdom that I met with on last weekend to have lunch and just kind of just chat about kink and allow her to ask some questions because she's kind of exploring that side. She's been more on the submissive side. And she happened to be coming to that I have on Tuesday nights, asked me if I would like to play. And so we did some suspension. She had not done any suspension before. So we did a partial suspension and some impact play. She hasn't been a dynamic and hadn't been playing in a while, and so we kind of incorporated both so she could get, you know, a little fix. Because she didn't have a lot of experience doing suspension, I didn't want to do like a full suspension, so we did a partial in kind of a position that is easy to spank her, and it was very fun, and I loved it. It was great, and she enjoyed it very much. And then once we were done with that, when people are new, I like to kind of give them the experience of suspension. So I tied up her other leg. I first just held it up to see if what I had tied her in was comfortable enough to be in a full suspension. She kind of tested that out and said she felt fine. And then she was kind of going in a little floaty space. So I tied that leg up and kind of let her enjoy that space just for a few minutes before I brought her down. I like to give them a taste. She wanted to do a full suspension. I didn't necessarily feel comfortable doing a full suspension, so we did a partial, and then I gave her a little taste, and I also saw how she reacted to that, so we don't have anybody freak out. So I would suggest tops when you are doing rope and someone has never done suspension before, never done rope before, start slow. Now, that was a great scene, and we actually forgot to discuss whether she wanted me to get pictures from the beginning, and if you don't talk to me about getting pictures from the beginning, I don't remember, because when I'm in a scene, I'm focused on the scene. I am lucky that I am able to get pictures, or I'm reminded by people who are watching my scenes, or the fact that I need stuff for this channel. One of the other suspensions I did was with my gentleman. I will have pictures of it somewhere again here. I will also have a video up on my Instagram page that I created. It's kind of just a little artistic video that I created when I was laying underneath him and playing with him and enjoying with him in his space. For that suspension, I did try a new harness. I tried a harness where I adjusted the stem and moved it to the side so I could load it from the side on the back. It turned out exactly how I planned it, which is the first time that I have done that. My suspensions normally turn out most of the way that I plan them out when I'm trying new things, but sometimes little things change and you find things that don't necessarily when you're tying yourself or you're mapping it out, engineering it, you run into issues when you're actually tying somebody else in it. This time, everything I planned turned out exactly how I had planned it to look, and it was awesome. And he said it was very comfortable and it was very beautiful, and it was an amazing scene. I also did some little extra decorative designs. I'm not someone who's like really about like super pretty rope. I'm more about the energy connection in the scene and making sure that I'm engineering it and doing safe suspensions, but I'm really more about creating whatever type of energy we're creating. So again, when it comes to pictures and stuff like that, like I'm not about super pretty rope. I hate to say I'm not about super pretty rope. It's just that that's not like my focus when I'm tying it. It's more about making sure that it's going to be sustainable and it's working for the suspension that I'm doing. And if it happens to be pretty, great. But for this suspension, I did do a little extra little artistry, and it also helped with the suspension and keeping it in place. Again, there'll be pictures. And again, it turned out how I planned it, which was awesome. And I'm excited to perfect that and get it to be even more pristine. For this suspension, one leg up and a ladder that loaded from the inside of the leg. So I was kind of playing with some different shapes. Again, it was really awesome. And I love when I do suspensions when I'm able to like get up underneath somebody and kind of get connections in that way. It's just really fun to create energy that way. So the other new challenge that I did this week with rope, I suspended my pet in a full suspension for the first time. She is a larger woman and was very nervous about doing suspension, really didn't think that it was going to be possible. And I did some research on this for about a month and planned out exactly what type of ties I thought would be good for a first suspension to be comfortable. Again, we're not trying to do some sadistic, crazy shapes. We're just trying to get her up off the air so she can get the feeling of it and get more used to it so we can do more things in the future. So for this, I also did a front loading harness. It wasn't a chest harness. It wasn't like the other one I had mentioned. It was different, not as intricate. It was more, again, about making sure that I had a steady structure for the suspension. For the lower part, I pretty much did like a mermaid type ladder rope all the way down her feet. And then I loaded everything in the front, one up line from the harness, and then four up lines on the down the legs, down the mermaid. And she was propped up like a hammock, just like this. She said everything was really comfortable. The weight was distributed really evenly. She looked absolutely beautiful. And mechanically, engineering-wise, as far as the rope, everything worked out well. My rope top was there just to help me, just in case I needed it. He had to help me with a couple up lines. But again, I think it was the way that I loaded it, and that if I load it differently in the future, that I should be able to suspend it myself. So I had a really great rope learning week. Yeah, I got to try out some new things. I'm blessed to have my gentleman and my pet who are adventurous and able to and willing to try new things with me. I'm trying to work on structures that are a little bit more creative, that aren't basic TKs or just basic harnesses. I love those because I use those for when I want to do suspensions and I want to play with people more. But sometimes I do suspensions and the rope and the suspension is the scene. And sometimes I do suspensions and I'm just putting them in a position for a scene. So this week it was more the rope was the scene, and it was really fun and rewarding. So those are my learnings from the week. Like I said, lots of rope, 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 rope. If you happen to find this video educational, entertaining, or enjoyable, again, like, share, subscribe, follow me at the MP Experience on all of my social media, blah, 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 blah. And thank you again for watching. I will be back next Monday with another vlog. I am doing my best to keep myself on schedule, so they may get posted late on Mondays or early Tuesday mornings. So thank you again for watching. This has been Madam Posh with the MP Experience. Should probably get after Care Bear down. He's been up here for a few days. Check out the rope book suggestions and happy kinking and farewell.